Everyone seems to be wondering what is going on with Halloween this year due to the pandemic. I ask three teenagers what they have in mind.
My favorite year was like, okay, I don't have a favorite year because every time I go trick-or-treating, I'm always with like one person and they're like, "Hi guys, like stop going so fast. Like it's just for fun. Like no, I want to get all the candy I can." And they're just like, "Guys, let's walk."
Probably second grade because I went with my neighbors and we had a lot of fun and I was like younger and then we went to all the houses and then there was like the house down the road and it had like the big candy bars and it had like the king size ones, so that was my favorite year.
I'd have to say like first grade because I think I went as Superman and my neighbor went as like, no, she went as Tinkerbell. She went as Tinkerbell. And we were like the duo that went around town. We had the best costumes, eighth grade. We had a great time.
I'm an Among Us character. It's a game, and you're like with a bunch of other people, and you have to like weed out who's the imposter, and like the imposter kills the other people playing.
A bunny.
So I took the least effort possible to just grab stuff out of my closet, and I came up with a hippie zookeeper. So that's what I'm going with.
Even if like it was acceptable for a 17-year-old to go trick-or-treating, I probably wouldn't because of Rona. So,
No, because I'm a big girl.
I was not. My neighbors are setting up little stands outside their houses that the kids are going to walk by and do a little socially distanced Halloween experience, but I wasn't interested in feeding into that.
I mean, has it really affected me? Because I'm not like going out. I'm just at your house now.
I'm not handing out candy this year because of the coronavirus.
Yeah, I wasn't gonna go out anyways, so not that much.
I think the real problem is the candy transferring. Because, like, if you stick your hand in a bucket of candy and then give it to a kid, I think masks aren't the, like, problem here.
Well, I think it's okay because it's outside. But the only thing is the candy, like a bunch of kids touch that. So like if they're gonna do that, they should hand out like individual bags with like the gloves on and stuff.
I think trick-or-treating could be okay, but not just with masks. We need other measures in place.
I feel like it all depends on the state of the virus. Like if it's still the same as next year, like I don't think it's gonna happen. But I feel like it's still gonna like be a tradition for Halloween because it's so popular and I don't think it's gonna stop.
I think it'll slowly get back to normal, but it might stay like this for a while. They might start doing it like with like gloves and like from now on they might have like, you know, the person will have a glove when they hand out the candy to the kids and then like the kids will have to like stay away and like, you know, have their mask on. So it's gonna be weird, but hopefully we have it.
I think if we are able to combat the virus, then I think trick-or-treating will become the same. Maybe it'll even get crazier, given that people will probably miss it this year.
Considering what they all had to say, I kind of agree with them that the virus has taken a toll on Halloween this year, but in the following years to come, trick-or-treating is a staple for families and kids, that so much so that this won't affect it for the years to come.